Okay, hi semua. Okay, so okay again, we start the lesson for today with the question number one. Okay, integrate 1 over x plus 5 square x minus 1 dx. Okay, now here we have the problem is we have to use the partial fraction. So this question start with the partial fraction. Okay, so the starting point will be. Okay, we need to identify what is a suitable partial fraction that can be work for this question number one. So here, since we have power of 2, then we need to use the repeated roots. Okay, which mean the number 2 dah. Okay, ini consider ialah kita panggil sebagai repeated roots. Ini kita panggil dia repeated roots. Okay, repeated roots maksudnya dia ada 2 kali. Okay, for example, here we since we have square, so it means we have to put ax plus 5 plus b over x plus 5 square, and then plus since we have another one x minus 1, so I have to add another function which is c over x minus 1. So we have three unknown to solve. Okay, so that will be the partial fraction. The partial fraction will have a, b, c because we have 3 functions here. Repeated roots, we have 2 and another function which is x minus 1. So, kita ada 3 dah kali ni. Okay, we have 3. Yeah? This time, we have 3. Okay, so since we have 3, so the partial fraction for this will be 1 over okay, x plus 5 square and then x minus 1 equal. That can be write as a over x plus 5 plus b over x plus 5 square plus c over x minus 1. Okay, this is what we get. Okay, so now we need to expand. Okay, now the problem is the expansion. Because of that, because of what? Because we need to go for the numerator. Remember, we need to identify what is the numerator. Okay, so the easy way to find the numerator is, okay, you see here, look at this. So here, the numerator is 1. So beautifully, no problem here. So numerator just will be equals to 1. So you dapat 1 lah dekat sini. 1 equal, okay. Di sini, okay, for the right hand side, okay, for this right hand side. Now the problem is we have 3 functions. You have x plus 5, x plus 5 square, and x minus 1. Okay, so here the problem is we need to get let's say we have 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 5. Maksudnya okay, the problem here, you see, now you have 2, 4, 5, right? So, this one's actually 2 square. So, you no need to times another 2 here. So, you just times 2, 2 times 5. You get the same as, okay, you get 20. Yeah, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 5 is 20. So, means here, just times 5. Here, you need to times 5, 4. Betul tak apa saya cakap ni? Are you following? Meaning that kita kali 1 sudah lah. Okay, yang ini kali. Okay, for this you need to times times 2 times 5. Okay, times 2 times 5. But here you no need to times 2, right? Here you just times 5 because you can get 20 ready. And here you need to times by 4 because 2 and 4 are related. So you just times 4, you get 20 ready. So, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to times here, okay, another function times by x plus 5 and times by x minus 1. So, I'll get a x plus 5 x minus 1 plus, okay, so here I need to times 2, right? One is plus 5, another one is minus 1. Okay, so then I can get the denominator same, right? Plus for b, okay, I no need to times another plus 5, okay, x plus 5 because it's already square. So I need to times by x minus 1 only. Okay, I need to times by x minus 1 only. Okay, for c, and here we need to times by what? We need to times by x plus 5 square. Okay, you need to times by 5 square because you times 5 square, you get the whole thing ready, this AB ready. So you get C will be x plus 5 square. Okay, any problem so far? Boleh ikut? Okay, so good. Okay, kalau tak ada masalah. Okay, next we continue with the for the value. Okay, we're going to substitute the value. Okay, what is the value I'm going to substitute now? Okay, correct. Okay, so x equal negative 5. So how I get negative 5? So x plus 5 equal to 0. X will be equals to negative 5. So the one we can substitute is negative 5. Okay, another one we can substitute is x minus 1 equals to 0. X will be equals to 1. So there is two values you can substitute. Okay, now we start with the substitution. So x equal negative 5, that will give you 1 equal, okay, a negative 5 plus 5, negative 5 minus 1 plus b negative 5 minus 1 plus c negative 5 plus 5 square. Okay, so the beautiful part here is this one make it 0, right? This one will be 0, right? So semua ni jadi kosong lah. So cancel, ni jadi kosong lah. Because once one of the value is times, okay, let's say one of the value is times, then the whole thing becomes zero. Because of what? Because anything times by zero will be zero, right? And same goes to here. This also will be zero. Because zero, all cancel. Tak payah lah. Okay, now you can go for the answer for B. B, we can go for the answer ready. So 1 equal, so here you get negative 5, you get negative 6 B, and B will be equals to what? Negative, okay, correct, negative 1 over 6. Okay, we already have the answer for B. B, we already have the answer, which is negative 1 over 6. Okay, next I proceed with the another substitution, x equals to 1. Okay, I go for another substitution, x equals to 1. Okay, 1 equal, okay, 1 equal, then a 1 plus 5, 1 minus 1 plus b 1 minus 1 plus c 1 plus 5 square. Okay, so when I do substitute 1, then beautifully this part will be eliminated. So b dah tak ada dah, ini jadi kosong dah. And same goes to your a, ini pun dah jadi kosong. So bila ni kosong, a also eliminated. So nicely eliminated. Okay, so we can go for the last answer, which is 1 equal, okay, 1 plus 5 is 6, 6 is 36. So 6 square by 36, so 36c, and c will be, okay, 1 over 36. So kita dapat jawapan ni. Okay, what is the next number I'm going to substitute? Yeah, correct, I put 0. Correct, I put 0. Okay, the easy one is you put 0. Okay, but this time you need to substitute B is C. Mesti kena cari, mesti kena ganti. Because of what? Because bila ganti kosong, you won't get 0 like this. Okay, you won't get 0 something like this. Okay, so in order to find A, okay, in order to find A, then now the substitution need to also B and C need to substitute inside the formula. Okay, mana kita nak ganti? Kita ganti pada numerator. Remember, eh, the numerator is 1 mark. Eh, you get this, you get 1 mark. Okay, if you get the correct answer, okay, you get 1 mark. Eh, because numerator is a very big thing when comes to partial fraction. Okay, you get this, you get 1 mark. Okay, any question lah? Any question? Partial fraction mesti ada markah untuk ni. Definitely we have marks for this. Depends on the condition lah. Eh? Okay, ini boleh satu markah, boleh dua markah. Depends on the question. Okay, but definitely there's a mark for this. Okay, depends on the question. Depends on the answer scheme lah. Eh? Okay, tapi mesti ada markah. Lah. Okay, kalau macam ni saya rasa boleh dapat dua markah. Lah. Possible. Okay, so very important. Eh, careful on this numerator. Okay, you get this answer correct, you get marks. Because the continuation will be everything referred to this. So wrong here, everything will be wrong. Okay, that's about the marks lah. Eh? Okay, so kita ganti balik dalam ni. Okay, so ganti balik 1 equal. Okay, 1 equal A times. Okay, here you get 0 plus 5. And then 0 minus 1. Okay, because x minus 1, right? Okay, 0 plus 5, 0 minus 1. And then B, we already have answer. So I put negative 1 over 6, 0 minus 1, plus 1 over 36, and then 0 plus 5 square. Okay, what is the answer? So the answer will be equal 1 equal, so 5 times negative 1, you get negative 5a. Okay, 5 plus 0 is 5. 0 minus 1 is negative 1. So 5 times negative 1, you get negative 5a minus. Okay, so I think negative negative will be positive, right? Yeah, correct. This one will be plus 6. Yeah, correct. 106 plus. Okay, correct. Plus 25 over 36. Okay, next, go for the last answer. Okay, so here since negative 5a, negative, right? So negative I bring here, 5a equal 1 over 6, 25 over 36 minus 1. So 1 over 6 plus 25 over 36 minus 1. Okay, well, anyone answer? 5a equal? Ah, yeah, it's supposed to get negative 5 over 36. Okay, you should get negative 5 over 36. Okay, and the last answer will be A equal, okay, divide 5, correct, negative 1 over 36. Okay, so kita dapat dah, negative 1 over 36. Okay, now substitute ABC into your integration. Now we go for the integration. Okay, so A is negative 1 over 36. B is just now is 1 over 6, right? 1 negative 1 over 6. And then C equal 1 over 36. Okay, so substitute these numbers, okay, into your integration. Okay, so we proceed for the integration. So integrate. Now the question is 1 over x plus 5 square and then x minus 1 dx equal integrate a over x plus 5 plus b over x plus 5 square plus c over x minus 1 dx. Okay, so I do substitution one by one. So a, b, c already we already make it as a partial. Now we go for substitution, which is your value a, b, c into your integration. Okay, so you proceed. You get what? You get equal integrate negative 1 over 36 divided by x plus 5 plus. Okay, so here we have negative 1 over 6 divided by x plus 5 square and then plus plus c. C is 1 over 36 divided by x minus 1 dx. Okay, now we go for the integration, right? By looking at here, we know for this answer can be changed as log, any logarithm. Can change to logarithm. So this one, you can change to ln. This one you can change to ln. This also you can change to ln. But here the problem here is this one is power of 2, so you have to use the polynomial formula. It's a polynomial formula. Before we go for the answer, do some modification. Don't just straight away do RAM. You must do everything together. Once I do, like this one you do, this one you don't do, and this one you do, it's not a good working. If you do integration, you must do completely. Not do the first one and then this one you haven't, and number three you already integrate. Don't do like that. So the good working is you do together. So you try to go for the some modification here before we want to do it together. So that will give you equal integrate negative 1 over 36, just copy back because we know the answer already. Here, this one, positive, I change to negative, negative 1 over 6, and this will be x plus 5, negative 2, and then plus 1 over 36 over x minus 1 dx. Now I think we can go for the answer. Okay, so the last answer will be equal. So since it's a logarithm, log problem, so I can put negative. Negative 1 over 36. Log x plus 5 minus 1 over 6 bracket. X power of over negative 1. What is your A? Apa A kita? A. Because remember the formula A plus B power of N divided N plus 1 divided by A N plus 1. A is 1. Sebab apa? Sebab why I remind you? Because sometimes you can have different value. So here you have x plus 5, but if you have 2 x plus 5, then you need to have the value of 2. So that's why I want to remind you that we have 1 times negative 1. It is not just negative 1. Eh? I want to remind you that it is 1 times negative 1. Where I get this one? This one is actually the A. Okay, A. Okay, and close bracket. Plus 1 over 36 log x minus 1 plus c. Okay, now we need to do some arrangement lah, so that it looks like a beautiful answer. Okay, we need to do like a simple modification here. Okay, so this part, okay, no problem. Negative 1 over 36 log x plus 5. Okay, ready. Here, negative, and here we got negative, so negative will be positive. Right? So this one become positive, 1 over 6, and this negative 1, so negative 1 better I put as a denominator. So 1 over 6 times x plus 5, because negative 1, right? Negative 1 must put as a denominator. So since we have 6, so together plus 1 over 36 log x minus 1 plus c. Okay, any questions so far? Will you good? Okay, anyone want to copy anything? You miss anything to copy? Dah, okay. Kalau tak ada masalah, okay, I pause for a while. Then we get the, okay, go for number 2 lah, question number 2. Okay, so here we have the problem number 2. Try to solve this. Okay, here we have problem number 2. Try to solve this. Okay, now think what is the suitable pattern that we can write for the partial fraction. Okay, try to break this x square plus 3x plus 5. Okay, sorry. Yeah, this one actually number 3 lah. Okay, it's actually pattern number 3 lah, ataupun form number 3 lah. Because of what? Because x square plus 3x plus 5, if you use calculator, you get something different. You won't get, it is not able to break. You see, look at the look at the calculator for answer. You get what? 1, 3, 5, right? So when you put, you get negative 1.5, right? Okay, careful with this, negative 1.5. But you see, look at the top of your, means on your screen also, you can see this. Okay, R something like, okay, equal something like I. Right? Do you have this in your calculator? Ah, okay. So meaning that yang ini kita tak boleh pecah macam biasa. So ini cannot break some, you cannot break something like usual you break. Because of what? Because it's a complex problem. Ini ada I. Imagine number. Ini R ni dengan I ni maksudnya ada complex number. You know, I think you know complex number, mesti ada I lah. Okay? But now we don't going to concentrate all this lah, but you should know, you should know what is complex number. Okay, so I'm not going to teach about complex number, don't worry. Okay, saya tambah fokus ni. But you cannot break this as usual lah. So here, since you cannot break this, okay, since you cannot break this, now you have to use, okay, the form number 3, pattern number 3, partial fraction. So, okay, so it is a, it's a, you cannot break this. So since you cannot break this, then it go, must go like quadratic. Okay, you go with the quadratic form. Okay, so I'll get what? I'll get, okay, so I need to go for the partial fraction, eh? So I go for the partial fraction. So the partial fraction will be, okay, the partial fraction, since we have quadratic, now I need to go for number, my partial fraction will be x square plus 6x plus 4 divided by, okay, divided by, here I get quadratic x square plus 3x plus 5 x plus 3 dx, sorry, no dx, because we take only the partial fraction, equal, okay, here we have quadratic x square plus 3x plus 5 plus, here we'll have the linear which is x plus 3. Now the problem here is, since you have quadratic here x square, definitely here will be ax plus b. Here this is the thing that you need to understand. When you have a quadratic here, here you must have ax plus b. Mesti kena ada macam ni. Okay, if you cannot break this, then the one you write, must write here is ax plus b. Plus, here you can put c, simply c. Ni sounds just c only. So this is the, okay, one of the form of the partial fraction where we need to understand. Okay, now go for the numerator. Get the numerator. What is the numerator? Go for numerator. So numerator will be, okay, so x square plus 6x plus 4 equal, it looks complicated, but actually the numerator will be easy to find. What times what? So you'll get ax plus b, and then times by x plus 3. Because of what? Because these two not same what? So not same means just cross multiply, this times by this, this times by this, just cross multiply because they are not same. So not same, no problem, just cross multiply only. Okay, and the other side will be plus c times x square plus 3x plus 5. Okay, you get this? Okay, you get this correct? You get marks for this. Okay, so now we already have the numerator. Now proceed for the substitution. Okay, what number which is suitable to substitute? Correct, negative 3 lah. Start with negative 3 lah. That is the one which is easy to substitute. It will make your calculation easier to go lah. Okay, so x plus 3 equals to 0. So x equals to negative 3. So negative 3 is one of the number which is make your calculation easier lah. So when x equals to negative 3, okay, so you can put negative 3 square plus 6 times negative 3 plus 4 equal, here you get negative 3a plus b times negative 3 plus 3 plus c times negative 3 square plus 3 times negative 3 plus 5. Wow, many numbers, huh? But the beautiful thing is, okay, you know, the beautiful thing is this one is become 0. That's the beautiful part. Okay, now put everything to your calculator. Okay, you can program also. Easy to find. Okay, so if you put your calculator, okay, negative 3 square plus 6. Okay, I do programming. Easy to go. X square plus 6x plus 4. So when I substitute negative 3, I'll get negative 5. Are you agree with me? So here I get negative 5. Are you agree with me? Siapa-siapa setuju dengan saya? Okay, negative 5, eh? Okay, so this side, okay, x square plus 3x plus 5. So when I substitute negative 3, I get 5c. So here I get 5c. So what is c? C is equals to? Correct, negative 1. Just negative 1. Okay, just negative 1. Okay, next. Next, we proceed for the substitution. Okay, since there is no value to substitute, okay, since there is no value to substitute, then the starting point will be very good is what? Start with? Correct, start with 0. Okay, so when you do substitution, okay, that number that you like, okay, then you need to put negative 1 inside the formula. Because when 0, you won't get C0. Okay, you cannot make it C0. So, meaning that you need to substitute C is negative 1. So, the negative 1 must substitute into the equation. Okay, so the easy thing is, all will be 0 if you have X. So, 0 plus 0 plus 4. Okay, why I put 0 plus 0 plus 4? Because 0 square is 0. 6 times 0 is 0. Plus 4 equal A times 0 is 0 plus B. Okay, 0 plus 3. You see, it becomes very easy to go. Because 0 is, that's the beautiful when it comes to 0. Plus C, I put 0 plus 0. But I substitute C, right? So I put negative 1. Okay, C I put here, negative 1. So negative positive change to negative. Okay, so I put here negative 1. Okay, C I put 0. C times 0 plus 0 plus 5. Okay. Okay, so what is your answer for B? So you get what? So here you get 4 equal And here you get 3b minus and negative 1 5, times 5, you get negative 5, right? Okay, b equals to, anyone want to try what is b? Yeah, correct. Okay, you get 9 equals to 3b, so b is supposed to be equals to 3, right? Okay, b should get 3, eh? Okay, next. Next number, I want to put what? Equal? Yeah, correct. Okay, 0 and 1. Okay, so now again, you need to substitute b, c also. In order to find a, you need to substitute the b value and c value. Okay, so I substitute 1, so I get 1 square, okay, plus, I 1 square, I put 1 lah, 1 square, I put 1, plus, 6 times 1 is 6, plus 4 equal, okay, 11 eh, A dapat 11 eh, no, I don't think so, A, I think you should get 2. Oh, okay. Yeah, correct. This one supposed to get 11, correct. Yeah, you are right. Okay, betul. Ini 11 lah. Okay, this side you get what? This side you get A plus 3, correct? Sebab A kali 1 dapat A lah. Plus 3, mana dapat? B lah, 3 lah. So, I substitute B is 3 times. And then, 1 plus 3, correct, 4. Okay, plus C, C negative 1, C is negative 1. Okay, C is negative 1, times, okay, 1 plus 3 plus 5. This is what I get when I substitute number 1. Okay, so for your left hand side, you get 11, 3a, and times 4, you get 12a. Hey, no, sorry. Ini akan dapat 3, 4 times a plus 3 minus. So this one is 1 plus 3, 1 plus 5 is, you get, okay, negative 9, right? Okay, so now we need to simplify. So 4a minus plus 12 minus 9, so we get what? A equals to, so 11 minus 12 plus 9, we get 8. So A will be 2, right? Okay, A will get 2. Okay, now, you already have answer for A. A is 2. B is 3. And then C is what just now? C is negative 1. Okay, now substitute into your equation. Okay, substitute all this into your equation. So you get what you'll get. Okay, go for the integration. So the integration will be integrate, and we get x square plus 6x plus 4 divided by divided by x square plus 3x plus 5 times x plus 3 dx equal integrate. Just now we get we put ax plus b over x square plus 3x plus 5 plus and this side you get c over x plus 3 dx. Now substitute. The substitution will be equal what? Equal integrate. A is 2, so 2x plus 3 over x square plus 3x plus 5 plus. So since c is negative 1, I change this one to negative. I put here straight away put negative 1 over x plus 3 dx. Since c is negative 1, I change positive to negative. Now we comes to the integration. How to integrate this? Now it's a very big question. How to integrate this? So this one no problem. This one should be no problem because it's a log answer, so not a problem lah. You can change to ln. How about this part? We have discussed this. Apa method kita nak guna dekat sini? What method is a suitable method to integrate this? Correct. Good point. Very good. You must do substitution. Very good. You start with the substitution. Since this one we cannot break, the one that we learned so far is the substitution method. So this part put as u. Denominator we change to u. This part we change to u. Now we go for the substitution we need to look into the substitution. So what substitution said? U equal x square plus 3x plus 5. U substitution said U equal x square plus 3x plus 5. What I need to find when I do substitution? Apa ke saya kena cari? I need to differentiate and find what? Find dx. I need to find dx. I kena tahu dx dia apa. We need to differentiate lah. We need to differentiate, but the one we want to find is dx. We need to find dx. So kita cari dx dia. So du over dx equal. You get what? You get 2x plus 3 lah. Now next, what is dx? Du, correct. Du over 2x plus 3. Or you can put 1 over 2x plus 3 du. same, right? You can put any of these. Okay, these two are same. Okay, now, now we can go for the integration ready. Okay, if you can figure out this, you can solve the problem ready. Okay, so we go for the integration. Okay, I go for the integration. I better I put here, equal. Okay, why not I do split this integration lah. So I do one by one lah. 2x plus 3 over s square plus 3x plus 5 dx minus integrate 1 over x plus 3 dx. I just split the integration so that I do one by one. Okay, which means easy to go, right? So I just split the integration. So one function I put here, another function I put here, and I integrate both sides. Okay, now for this equal, for this part I get equal. Okay, will be equal, integrate 2x plus 3 divided by what? Divided by, no, it should be 2x, 1 over. No. What I need to put here? I need to put here u. Correct. Betul. 2x plus 3 over u times dot. And here I put. Either I put this or this. Both also can lah. Dua-dua boleh. Actually, dua-dua boleh. Okay, I prefer. Okay, the number 2. Right? Okay, I don't know why everything is missing. Sorry for this. Okay, ini ialah u, ini ialah dx, ini ialah dan ini sama dengan 1 over 2x plus 3 du. Okay, since we have limited space, so I put number 1 lah. So I put du over 2x plus 3. Okay, now I cancel this. Ini boleh beautifully cancel. That's the reason. Itu sebab kita bawa substitution. Okay, that's the reason we need to bring the substitution, because we can cancel this. Okay, now we can go for the last answer. Minus, so this part, okay, no problem in integrate. So I copy back only. Now equal, integrate 1 over u du minus integrate. Then I think I go for the answer. So this one I get what? I get log x plus 3 plus c. What about this answer? Log. This one also log, right? 1 over u. Okay, correct. Log u. Okay. Minus log x plus 3 plus c. Okay, one more step to go. What is the answer? Correct. Substitute u back. Correct. Okay, ganti balik u. So answer equal log x square plus 3x plus 5 minus log x plus 3 plus c. So that's the answer. Okay, that's the answer. Okay, so so anything kalau nak tengok mana-mana yang atas, beritahu. Okay, if you miss copying anything, inform me, eh, so that I can scroll up back. If no problem, then we take 5 lah. Okay, kita ambil sedikit masa, kita break dulu because it's a complicated questions. We go for a 5 minutes break lah. Okay, if no problem, we take 5 minute break lah. Eh? Okay, now time is 10:52, 53. Okay, we start 11 lah. Kita sambung balik 11 o'clock. Okay, we'll bagi lebih masa sikit. Okay, again, we continue back with the question number 3. Okay, we try to do question 3 lah. Eh? Okay, so what is our starting point? Again, we start with the partial fraction. Okay, kita cuba pergi dengan partial fraction. Start with the partial fraction. Okay, so here partial fraction will be x minus 3 divided by okay, 2x square minus 6x plus 9 times x plus 2 can be break into okay. So check whether your calculator can solve, can simplify the quadratic or not. So when you put in your calculator, when you put your calculator, you get 2, 96, 9, right? So you get again this problem also. I think this one 6, eh? 6 positive, right? Sorry. Okay. Same thing. You get, you cannot solve also because you get real, I mean a complex number. Okay. So you cannot split the quadratic. So since it's a, this problem, this quadratic cannot be break into another simplest linear form, then the only way we have is we need to break into the form number 3 lah, pattern number 3 partial fraction, which is ax plus b divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 9 plus here we have c over x plus 2. Okay, so satu mesti ada linear, quadratic mesti kena ada, atas dia mesti ada linear. Okay, kalau linear mesti ada constant. Okay, that's the thing that you should remember. Yang ni quadratic. See, ini mesti linear. Dia mesti power 1, kurang 1 power. Ini linear. Ini quadratic. Okay, yang ni constant. Okay, bawah dia mesti linear lah. Dia mesti kurang power 1 power. So, ini kuasa 1, ini kuasa kosong. Okay, that's the logic behind this form lah. Eh? This quadratic form. Sorry, this partial fraction form. Okay, now we go for the numerator. So numerator you get what? X minus 3 will be equal. Okay, anyone want to try? What is the answer? So you get A X plus B. Correct, X plus 2. Correct, plus C times. Okay, correct. 2x square plus 9 plus 6x plus 9. Okay, now we go for the substitution lah. Okay, once you get the numerator, you are very close to the answer already. Okay, you will be very close to the answer. Okay, and next we go for the substitution. So what is the suitable value? The first value you can substitute, then start with the x. Correct, start with x plus x minus 2 right? Because x minus 2 will give you 0, x plus 2 is start with 0, so x equals to negative 2, so start dengan negative 2, that will be your first number to be substitute. So x minus 2, okay, then negative 2 minus 3 equal, and you get negative 2a plus b times negative 2 plus 2 plus c times 2 times negative 2 square plus 6 times negative 2 plus 9 close bracket. Okay, one thing nice here is this part will be 0 lah. Ni jadi kosong lah. That part will be 0. Okay, now you need to figure out what is the value for C. So I just program the calculator. So 2x square plus 6x plus 9. Then I get negative 2 means I'll get 5. Right? Okay, I get 5C. Are you agree with me? Negative 5 equals to negative 5C. Betul, eh? So negative 5 equals... Correct, C is negative 1 lah. Okay, C is will be negative 1. Yes. Okay. Okay. Okay, eh? So we already have C equals to negative 1. Okay, next. Next, I go for another substitution. Okay, next I go for another substitution. Correct, start with X equals to 0. Correct. Okay, start with X equals to 0. So you'll get 0 minus 3 equal... Then A will be 0 plus B and 0 plus 2 plus C. So since we have B and C, so C must substitute lah. Okay, you need to have one constant only, one unknown only. So B need to substitute. So you put negative 1 here, bracket, and then 0. Plus 0 plus 9. Because anywhere you put 0, all the numbers will be 0. Right? Okay, C I need to substitute because I want to find B, right? Okay, so C need value, right? We need to put this value. Okay, now I think I get negative 3 equal B times 2, I get 2B. And here, I think we get negative 9. What is the answer? Okay, correct. Okay, so ini akan dapat 6 equals to 2b, so b will be 3 lah. Okay, 3 sama dengan B actually bukan kata salah lah. Okay, 3 sama dengan B ni sebenarnya tak betul lah. Actually this one, that's why you see I put unknown baru saya put value. Okay, so if we get this, change it to B equals to 3 lah. Senang dah nampak. Okay, ini macam belum selesai lagi. Nampak macam belum selesai lagi. If you put B equals to 3, saya pun nampak direct you punya answer. So that's why when you see my writing usually I put unknown answer. Practice like this. Practice the way that unknown answer. That will be make the examiner ataupun make like the marker easier lah. Macam saya nampak, saya terus bagi marker lah. Okay, make my work easier. Okay, so I recommend you to write this. Saya recommend buat benda ni. Ini cantik. Write this. Okay. If you get this, okay, no problem. But change it to this. Last answer, you put B equal 3. Okay, next. Next, I want to put 1. X equals to 1. So 1 minus 3 equal, so A will be AX, so we get A plus B, we need to substitute, B is 3 times, 1 plus 2. C is negative 1, so I put negative 1 times. And then 2 plus 6 plus 9. Okay, because 2 x square. So x square will be 2 times 1 square, right? So I get 2 times 1, I get 2. 6 times 1, I get 6. So I just put the value, last answer only. Okay, now I go for find the last answer. 1 minus 3 is negative 2 equal. So 3, again same thing, 3 times a plus 3 minus. Okay, so this side I get 2, 6, 9. I get negative 11, negative 17. Okay, I get negative 17, because 2 plus 6 plus 9, I get negative 17. And then continue with this, I get negative 2 equal 3a plus 9 minus 17. So 9 minus 17, we get negative 8. Okay, so I think a will be 2. So you get negative 2. I think straight away I put the last answer. So please check your answer. So I put the last answer. A equals 2. 2. Okay. Any problem? Okay. You can discuss. Okay, if no problem, then we go for the integration. Okay, so I go for the integration. So the integration part will be integrate. Okay, x minus 3 divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 9 times x plus 2 dx. Equal, okay, then you get ax plus b divided by 2x square plus 6x plus 9 plus c over x plus 2 dx. Okay, substitute a, b, c. So a is 2. Okay, b is 3. C is negative 1. B is 3 and c is negative 1. Correct, 2x plus 3, correct. Okay, divided by. Okay, 2x square plus 6x plus 9 plus minus. Okay, correct. Dx, correct, correct, good. Okay, betul. Wow, dia jadi ganti u lah. Okay, now we need to proceed with the u substitution. Okay, wait, hold on. Okay, so start with u. U equal 2x square plus 6x plus 9. Okay, so du dx. Okay, equal. Okay, correct. 4x plus 6. What is our dx? Okay, correct. Tambah du, correct. Okay, equal. Okay, so we, if we know this, okay, then we can continue for the integration. Equal, integrate. Okay, 2x plus 3 divided by u. And, okay, dot. Okay, okay, 1 over. Okay. Okay, minus, okay, kan, boleh dah, okay, log x plus 2 plus c, correct, okay, maksudnya kita ini integrate lah, okay, kan, boleh, good, okay, next step is what? Okay, correct. Betul, betul. Good. Okay, we need to factor. The one you need to do is now you need to factor, cancel the 2x plus 3. So, the one you need to do is you need to factor out this. Look at this. 2x plus 3, 4x plus 6. So, they are related actually. But they are not direct. Direct copy. So, now you need to factor and we simplify. So you can simplify this, cancel with the one in the numerator. Okay, so you can cancel this. So this one, cut, you cancel with this. Minus log x plus 2 plus c. Okay, so next step will be equal. Equal what? Okay, correct. 1 over 2. Okay, 1 over 2. Okay, correct. Log u. Tolak. Okay, correct. Plus 2 plus c, very good. Then u will be. Okay, good. Okay, good. So 2x square plus 6x plus 9 minus log x plus 2 plus c. Very good. So this is our answer. Okay, very good. Okay, good try. Okay, remember the substitution. Okay, not always you'll get the same number like this 2x plus 3, 4x plus 6. Not always you get the same thing But there will be some relation. For your syllabus, okay, definitely they won't ask too tricky question lah. Only like factor lah. Only like factor only. The maximum they gave you is something like this, factor only. So you must know how to factor out and cancel the one in the numerator. So once we cancel the numerator, you can solve the problem ready. Okay, so we have completed the partial fraction lah. So even I discussed the complicated also. I think you have enjoyed learning this partial fraction. I hope lah. Okay, so next part I'm going for double integration. Saya nak masuk double integration. Soalan final. Hold on, Okay. Now we're going to continue with the double integration. So the first formula, first question I'm going to give you is integrate x dx. Okay, integrate x dx. X dx dx. Why we have two times? Because we need to integrate two times. So definitely we need to have the dx function twice. Okay. So first thing we need to do is integrate what the first thing here. You need to solve what is integration of x respect to dx. Okay, that will give you equal integrate. So x will give you x square over 2 plus c dx. Okay, you get this. So the first answer, when you integrate x, you get x square over 2 plus c dx. Then we go for another integration. So the another integration will give you, okay, remember, before you go for the integration, remember this is what I taught you. So when you have fraction, put it front, 1 over 2, x square plus c dx, put it front, because that will be make your calculation easier. Remember always the constant you put it front. When you put it front, now you see you get easy to go, 1 over 2, bracket, now you get what? X power of 2, you get x power of, correct, x power of 3 over 3 plus cx. Okay, so since I get cx, right, so I put c1 and I put c2, right? Okay, I put c1, c2, because these two are constant, but they are not same, right? Okay, just to differentiate c1, c2, ataupun kalau kita guna c1, c2, you put another number also can. You put C plus D also can. No problem on C. Let's say you don't like C1. Okay, you put C here. Okay, you put C here. And then final answer, you put D. Can, no problem. CX plus D. Okay, acceptable, no problem. Okay, same thing only. Mesti kena CX because this one is constant what? Sebab C kalau kita integrate, yeah correct, C kita integrate, kita akan dapat CXY. That's why I pun miss tadi, because I thought dia constant, dia just constant je. But actually when we need to integrate the constant also, that's why we get CX. Okay, what is the last answer? So the last answer will be equal, correct, 1 over 6 x power of 3 plus, okay, correct, cx plus d. Very good. So this is our last answer. Okay, number 2. Okay, number 2. Okay, come, try to do this. Integrate, let's say I give you 2x plus 3 dx dx. Okay, so the answer will be equal. So integrate. Okay, remember to integrate this. Okay, we need to do the first one. First one inside lah. Kita kena integrate yang dalam dulu. So the first integration will be 2x square over 2 plus 3x plus c dx. Okay, 2x square over 2 plus 3x plus c. Now, once we want to cancel the 2, because they are same, so I just cancel the constant. So, I get the simplified answer. Simplified answer will be equal. Integrate x square plus 3x plus c dx. Now, I proceed for another integration. So, because of double integration, I need to proceed for the another integration. Okay, what is the answer? Equal. Okay, correct. X power of 3 over 3 plus. Correct. 3x square over 2. Correct. Plus. Plus. Okay, cx plus d. Now we do some arrangement here. So the arrangement will be equal 1 over 3 x power of 3 plus 3 over 2 x power of 2 plus cx plus d. So that is the last answer. Okay, any question so far? Ada apa-apa nak tanya saya? Tak ada, eh? Can follow lah. Eh? Okay, next, number 3. This time, I give you, okay, last time semua ni repeat, same kan? Dx, dx kan? Now, I give you different. Xy, dx, dy. What we going to do now? Now, we have different thing. The differentiation, I mean the integration have. No. We do one by one. So here, this one, we do one respect to dx. So the first integration is respect to dx. And the second integration is respect to dy. Okay, now if you have if you integrate respect to x, you just integrate the x only, the y remain constant. Okay, y will be constant for there. So equal integrate. Okay, now I'm going to integrate what? I'm going to integrate x, right? Because this one is a dx. So we need to integrate respect to dx. So when dx means I need to go for x. Right? So x, I get what? X square over 2. Y, correct. And then plus c, correct. And then correct, I get dy. Very good. So this is what I should get. Okay, x square over 2 y plus, better I put bracket here. Okay, x square over 2 y plus c dy. Okay, the next one will be what? Next one will be equal. Okay, before I go for the integration, better I take out the constant. So 1 over 2 x square y plus c dy. Now I need to consider only y. Second thing, y sahaja. So I need to integrate anything y, I integrate. Kalau dia tak ada y, then I put y because constant lah. Okay, what is my answer? Huh? Yeah? Okay, equal. Okay, again, try again. 1 over 2. Okay, correct. X square over 2, x square. Okay, correct. Y square over 2, very good. Plus. Okay, correct. Correct. So kita akan dapat cy plus d. Okay. Now we arrange this. We arrange this. We get what? We get 1 over 4. Okay, correct. Very good. So inilah jawapan kita. Okay, good. Okay, so you get this, you know, you understand the idea behind the double integration. So you integrate, if you have x, dx means you must integrate respect to x. Siapa yang ada x, you differentiate dia. You integrate dia. Yang tak ada x, you tambah x untuk dia. Okay, same goes to dy. Siapa yang ada y, you integrate dia. Okay, same thing only, similar things only. Okay, next. Next, number 4. Integrate, let's say I give you sine exponent y plus y exponent x dy dx. Okay, so our answer will be equal. First, do the integration inside. So, mesti buat yang dalam dulu. Okay, continue with the inside. Okay, solve inside, then go for the outer one. Okay, now, integrate. Okay, integrate. Okay, now, you are differentiate, you are integrate respect to y. So, siapa yang ada y? So, ini ada y. Okay, ini ada y dan ini ada y. So dua-dua ada y lah. Okay, so since the function f y, so we get what? X exponent y. Because when you integrate exponent y, you just get exponent y lah. Plus. Plus what? Correct. You get y square over 2 exponent x plus c dx, correct. Ini kena dapat tambah c, correct. Okay, plus c. Okay, the constant must be there. Because when you integrate second time, you get cx ready. So, mesti kena ada constant ni. Okay, next, go for the equal. Okay, ini dapat apa? Ini akan dapat x. So x akan jadi, okay, correct, x square over 2 exponent y plus, okay, this one copy back, y square over 2 and exponent x, kalau kita integrate dia dapat balik exponent x plus cx plus d. Okay. And then finally, I put the constant front. So 1 over 2, x square, exponent y, plus 1 over 2, y square, exponent x, plus cx, plus d. Okay, last question for today. Last question for today lah. Sudah penat dah hari ni. Okay, number 5. Okay, number 5. Integrate. Okay, double integration. Number 5. Why not I give you sine. Sine 2x plus exponent 3y dy dx. What is this answer? Equal okay, anyone volunteer want to try integrate? Okay, now you see, you jangan letak y dekat belakang, you letak y dekat depan. Y sine 2x macam ni. Okay, why I say that, because let's say, kalau you letak macam ni 2xy, takut nanti kita combine y ni dengan x. That's why we don't recommend this. Ini kita tak mau, because we might confuse with this answer. If you see, kalau kita ada sine trigonometry, right, especially, any number don't put behind trigo. So any number, any const, any variable, better you put front the constant, front the trigo. Kalau pun, kalau lah kita dapat exponent pun sama, better we put it front, because we might confuse with the sine trigo ni. Okay, so better we put y it is front lah, because when you integrate sine 2x respect to y means you can dapat y kan, because this is a constant. So you get y sine 2x plus plus what? Correct. 3 exponent 3y bukan. 3 exponent 3y ialah differentiation. Correct. Okay, so you should get exponent 3y divided by 3 plus c dx. Ini saya recall balik, remember this d dx exponent ax. So just to recall lah, you get a exponent ax. Saya tahu kenapa you ingat sekarang integrate differentiation. Semalam baru test kan, so you dah pulun. Sekarang semua differentiation you ingat. Okay, tak apa, nanti kita kena pandai jugalah integration. Integration belum lagi test, so you belum lagi ingat lah. I know this, so it's okay, I understand this. So you need to recall this. So kalau differentiate, a pergi depan. Kalau kita integrate, then a dia ada dekat bawah. A will be is as a denominator, you put down here. Okay, so next is what? Equal. Now we need to differentiate, we need to integrate respect to dx. Okay, now sine 2x, you get what? Negative 2x over 2 or times 2? Over 2 or times 2? Dia macam ni, dia sama ikut ni, dia sama follow ni. Kalau di integration, kalau differentiation di depan, integration mesti bawah. So you get negative y sine, I think better I put this, I say man. Okay, luckily got the number. Okay, luckily tak hilang. Okay, so you buat macam ni, y bracket negative sine become cos, right? Cos 2x divided by 2. Put down here. Integration constant to the bawah. Remember this. Plus exponent 3y divided by 3 plus cx plus d. Tambah x yang mana? Tambah x yang mana? Oh yeah 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 right yeah right yeah correct correct. Oh correct. So ini kena tambah x. Betul 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 betul. Ah yeah, I think I better recall this. Okay. So, okay, thank you. Thank you for reminding me. Betul, saya dah miss dia ni. Okay, good lah. Okay, ini sebab ni ada y, ini constant, jadi kita kena tambah x dekat sini. Thank you. Thank you for reminding me. So you get exponent 3y over 3 x plus cx plus d. Sebab ini ini akan jadi constant. Okay, ini akan jadi constant. Okay, and now we do some small arrangement lah before we give the last answer. So last answer will be negative 1 over 2 y cos 2x. Kan tambah. Okay, correct. 1 over 3x exponent 3y plus. Okay, very good. So this is our last answer. Okay, 1 negative 1 over 2y cos 2x plus 1 over 3x exponent 3y plus cx plus d. Okay, so itu ialah jawapan untuk nombor 5 lah. Okay, so itu saja untuk hari ini. Hold on.